Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, which is your station where you have been watching to learn. I'm your teacher, Mr. Mangi Francis, and today I'll be taking you through rates of reaction, lesson 2, where we'll look at effect of temperature. What are the goals of this lesson? So by the end of this lesson, you'll be able to explain how temperature affects the rate of reaction in terms of coercion theory. So we need first to understand or to remind ourselves of what is coercion theory. So for a reaction to occur, the particles of the reactants must collide for them to form products. During the reaction, not all coercions lead to formation of products. Only the successful coercions lead to formation of products. And for the reacting particles to start reacting, they need some energy. So the minimum energy required by the reacting particles is what we refer to as activation energy. So what is temperature and how does it affect the rate of reaction? Temperature is defined as the degree of hotness or coldness of a place or a substance. And it is not the same throughout the day or at different times of the day or from one place to another. It keeps changing. And therefore, the rate of reaction, whether we use the same concentration or the same reagents, the same, that is, the rate of reaction will not be the same. It is expressed in kelvins or degrees Celsius. So let us look at the following illustration to see whether we'll be able to understand how temperature affects the rate of reaction. Effect of temperature on rate of reaction. So by heating, we increase the rate of the reaction. That is, we increase the temperature, and the substance being heated absorbs the heat energy. So the particles absorb the heat energy and start vibrating. So as they vibrate, they knock on one another. That means they collide, and as they start colliding, this increases the number of collisions per unit time, and this will lead to an increase in the rate of the reaction. And as we continue heating, as you can see, the vibration of the particles increases. In solid state, the particles can be triggered, or they acquire enough energy so that they can move from the lattice, crystal lattice, where they are held together, and they break from one point to another. So what about, what can we explain, or which explanation can we use to be able to understand this? So increase in temperature results to an increase of the kinetic energy of the particles. So this makes the particles to move faster and collide more frequently with sufficient energy. And this causes more collisions per a given time. And this is what increases the rate of the reaction. Using a graph, we can be able to understand this much better. And this leads us to be able to apply this concept, be it in solving questions related to rate of reaction or applying this in industrial processes. By looking at the graph which we have here, you can see that we have two curves. We have one curve where we have the blue and the red curve. We all have the same amount at the end of the reaction. But the higher the temperature, the higher the concentration of the small pieces. And as you can see from the blue curve, we are able to reach at the products faster than the red curve, where the temperatures are low. That means they don't have enough kinetic energy. They collide slowly. The number of collisions per unit time is very less, but we end up finally arriving at the same product. So let's see whether we are able to get this concept by attempting the following activity. Explain the effect of the following on the rate of reaction in terms of coercion theory. Number one, increase in temperature, and B, decrease in temperature. How does increase in temperature affect the rate of reaction? And how does decrease in temperature affect the rate of a given reaction? You can as well as refer from the following books or resources for you to be able to grasp this concept much better. Thank you for staying with me and welcome.